On behalf of the organizing committee, I cordially welcome you all to this opening ceremony of the Chorus Chess Tournament 2001. It is the 63rd tournament in succession, which started as Hoogovens Schaaktoernooi in 1938. Especially, I would like to welcome our special guests, the 14 Grandmasters who will play in the Grandmaster Group A during the 2 weeks to come.
Ladies and gentlemen, it gives me great pleasure to declare the 2001 Chorus Chess Tournament officially opened. Thank you.
The next Grandmaster that I will introduce has been the leading player since 1985 when he took over the world title from Anatoly Karpov. Since that moment he proved every year again that he is the absolute number one. In 2000 he won Wijnkansee, Linares and Sarajevo. However, Kasparov suffered a great setback when he lost his world title to Vladimir Kramnik. I'm sure that he will do his utmost in Wijnkansee to prove that he's still the best. If he will win here, he is the first player who wins Wijnkansee three times in a row. Ladies and gentlemen, from Russia, the 37 years old Garry Kasparov.
Number 8
for Mr. Kasparov. The next player reached the top 10 quite rapidly. In sports, it is known, however, that staying at the top is maybe even more difficult than reaching it. Peter Leko, still only 21 years old, proved that he has been capable of this difficult task. Last year he had no exceptional results, but he is still a clear top 10 player. From Hungary, Peter Leko.
Number 1.
Leko against Fedorov, and for the non-chess player, the first name has white. Shirov against Topalov, Piket against Moros Legic, Timman against Kramnik, Van Veli against Ivanchuk, Adams against Anand, and Tiviakov against Kasparov.
Somehow you are getting really fascinated by this chess, and once you go very deep into it, then you see, okay, there are 64 squares on the board, but the possibilities are just unlimited. It just even if you think you know already almost everything about chess, then you have to wonder that you still know very little. It's somewhere like life as well. So once you get this fascination and you train a lot, then you start to like this chess game very much. Then you also realize it's not only a game, it's a sport, it's also an art. And all together very compact, and you just love it. I started playing chess at the age of 7, which is actually a little bit late for the other chess players, because many chess players start at already age of 4, 5, but when I started at 7, I started instantly and with very big emotions. They immediately told me that I'm a very big talent. I have to do everything in chess. I can reach everything. And these were only the early stages. Yes, I was just 7, and when I was 9 years old, I was already the best player in my town, and then I had to move to another place, to Kecskemét. This was 80 kilometers away from my hometown Szeged, where there were many international and grandmasters who I could train with, and then I could get a better feeling.
Ja, Peter Leko is een bijzondere deelnemer aan ons toernooi, want hij heeft
Nou, het exacte jaartal, dat schiet me nu niet te binnen, maar hij heeft hier ooit zijn derde grootmeesterresultaat gehaald in Wijk aan Zee. Toen speelde hij nog in de reserve, of een reservegroep of de grootmeestergroep B. Nou, dat wil ik even vanaf zijn, maar in ieder geval heeft hij die prestatie toen hier geleverd. En toen was hij daarmee meteen de jongste grootmeester van de wereld. Ik geloof dat het record later wel weer door iemand anders is verbeterd. Maar hij heeft toen toch voor de nodige publiciteit voor het toernooi gezorgd en aandacht. Het was een wonderkind, zoals het heet.
Yes, in 94. In 94 I became here the youngest grandmaster. Yeah.
How was that?
Was great.
Yeah.
Was definitely great. I played really very well. And was very pleased because winning this youngest grandmaster title really meant me a lot. Because I was coming from a poor family with very limited possibilities, financial possibilities, and this was somewhere the breakthrough that you get invitation for the big tournaments where you can fight against the best players, also earn money in order to, not for yourself, but simply to sponsor your chess career further. I have from January 3 trainers. One is Artur Yusupov. He's a former Russian grandmaster living now in Germany. Former world candidate, very strong player. Another is Amador Rodriguez, a Cuban grandmaster. He's now living in Spain. And my third trainer is Arshak Petrosyan. He's an Armenian grandmaster. And he is now coming to Szeged to be my trainer there, my main trainer. And I really hope that this work will be very productive.
He has a lot of abilities. He is a very talented player. And he already reached a very high level in chess. But at the same time, he still has to learn a lot of things. And here I see a lot of potential because he can gain experience. He needs to know different types of positions and he can improve his technique. He can improve his openings repertoire. So he has a lot of possibilities to improve.
Так, ну, слон же 4. Я думаю, тоже так.
I started my management with Peter nearly 3 years ago, but I know him well since when he was 11 years old. I saw him in 91 first in Dortmund, and I saw immediately that something, that some development around this guy could happen. But I never asked him for the management, it's my profession. But 3 years ago, after a tournament as well in the Netherlands, in Tilburg, he was asking me to do this job, and then it starts. And I think we had a big success. At this time he has been number 16 in the world, with big economic problems, of course, because he has many responsibilities and not the right team around him. Now I think he has nearly everything. The concert is complete, so that he can improve and concentrate on his chess.
Окей, спасибо. Normally, the preparation always starts that I work here on the machine first, look at the games of my opponent, and then a special position I look later at the chessboard. This is the... So now I will play tomorrow Adams, so I'm trying to search making with some. And then I can even check the time when which games I want to see from Adams. That's from the last 3 years, from 98 to 2001. Then I just press here a button, and then I will get all his games, what he played with black in the last 3 years. It's quite a lot. And here I can see who played the games, and here I can see what were the moves. So I can see if it was interesting for me or it wasn't. So far these games are played with d4, this is not what I play. I play normally the e4, and then I'm searching for his games with black. Then slowly when I see that this opening is interesting, then I'm having a look at it.
Ik weet, jullie zitten op 8, hè?
Ik zie die meteen niet.
Ja, oké.
Okay. Ja, dank je. Hoi, hoi. Hoi, het was al helemaal niet meer.
Some of the most important thing is that you feel relaxed and you feel comfortable before the game, but unfortunately many times this is not the case. This is, yeah, because you really just find some holes. What you thought it's all okay, and then you maybe switch 10 minutes before your game. I cannot play this line, then I have to play something that I never played, while my opponent already knows this. And then what should I do? Should I play for win? Should I just play for draw? But I want to play. There are also a lot of spectators. Everybody expects you to fight well. So even if you feel you are in bad shape, you still don't want to make a quick draw. And then things are getting worse and worse. Of course, sometimes it's exactly the opposite. You really feel well, you find a good move, you are waiting for your opponent, and then he plays completely different, but you have already good emotions. So you can handle the situation, the new situation over the board also very comfortably, very well, and then you just play a perfect game. So this many times what you do over the chessboard reflects how you felt in the morning, and this is somewhere connected.
I'm coming from Armenia, from the Yerevan. This is the capital of the country.
And how did you meet Peter?
First, I wanted to study in Germany. This was the point. I was learning the German language, the school, and then also private. And then my family went also to Germany to give me this possibility to learn there. My father was playing then there in the summer in this Dortmund Schachtage in Open, and there was playing also Peter, and so we met each other just very suddenly. I was coming every day to watch the games of my father, and then suddenly Peter was giving some comments for his game, and just it happened, yes. Because very suddenly.
How is life with a grandmaster? Hmm? How is it to be the wife of a...
It is difficult, you know. It is not so easy. Okay, it is also not so difficult, but it is not just this normal life. Yes, like all families are having. It is not like this. And it has good sides and also difficult sides. It is very hard to explain. But also this traveling is also not so easy. This is the point. And always when you are watching these games, you are always very nervous. And this is difficult. This is difficult. My father was training in Germany. Mm-hmm. Chess trainer and playing also for a chess club. Then Peter made this offer. And then my father was agree. Course, and so they will start this year. My parents are going now to Hungary from the March, and then they are starting to train.
Are you really looking at the other games, or are you just still with your own game?
No, you are trying to follow the other games as well, because there's always a lot of interest, because you know that you have to play this player as well in 2 or 3 days, then you are also interested what he plays against this player, and you are also somehow relaxing by this. Well, when you are always fully concentrated there, then you fix to some of the ideas, yes? Now you calculate very long line, and then suddenly you go, you stand up, go away, you look some other games, and then you get a fresh view. Wow, but what I was considering here for 20 minutes, this move and the whole variation is immediately finished, yes? And things like this can happen. And of course, at the main time, you are not losing your concentration about your game, because you are really trying to get some fresh view about the position. This is also the reason why many times the spectators see some move that the players fully concentrated don't see. Because when you are fully concentrated, you are going very deep into some variations. You calculate really a lot, like 4 or 5 other games as well. And at the moment, you can only make one move, even if you're considering 20, 30 other alternatives. And then the spectators with a fresh view just see, wow, but here this move is just very strong. And when you're fully concentrated, then you don't see it. So you have to get somehow also this ability to be very well concentrated, but also ready for every new idea.
Immediately after the game?
That is exactly the problem, actually. It's very hard to relax because the level of concentration was so high that the mind continues to work, and that maybe also in the night you can wake up and say, ah, that was a right move. I missed this right move in the game. So it continues, the brain continues to work, and that is a problem. So you need to then to relax somehow, to switch attention, maybe to walk and to do something else. But it is not easy, because mind will continue to work.
Yes, well, you are trying to sleep, but somehow you can't. And then, of course, you are also getting nervous, because you know that without good sleep, you cannot play good. But still, these things disturb you. And even if you turn to the right side, there is also another position. If you turn to the left side, it's again some problems. And then, okay, luckily, somewhere in between, you fall asleep, and then you can rest. But if you really go to sleep with those thoughts, then you can't sleep very well. And then things are getting worse and worse. So this is also one of the key things to sleep well. I also have to learn this for the future.
Pizza, aber klein und mit Champignons. Dazu.
Gut. Dann ich nehme diese Melanzane Parmigiana.
Ja.
Und dann ich nehme diese Penne Arrabbiata.
Ja.
Ja.
Okay.
Ja. Okay. Ja. Ja.
Schaak!
Ja, nou wordt het
geen schaak, het kan mat zijn.
Ja, mat. Nee, mijn pion gaat de andere kant op. Pak hem!
Ja, 5
speel.
G3.
Ja. Nou, nog eens ja.
Ja, want als je dan op dame F3 en Victor F1.
Ja. Ja, prachtig hoor.
Kijk, dus je gaat niet op, B7. Hè? Een paar dagen.
Ja, Gera 3.
om het blok van zwart te breken.
Door 4-8.
Ja?
Koning Hendrik 1.
En loper F8?
Ja.
Loper V8.
Ja. Nou, dat wint zwart wit om rekening te houden met zijn dame. Hij moet met een zet als loper G4 gaan rekenen. Soms kan dat betekenen dat de dame verloren gaat, ik geloof hier nog niet, maar loper G4 wint de dame voor de kwaliteit.
Ik wou ook erbij zeggen dat beide tegenstanders, Anand en Leko, hebben uitzonderlijke schaakgeheugen en schaakkennis. En ik zou niet verbaasd kijken dat deze stelling ook geen nieuwe stelling voor beide is.
Dit heeft natuurlijk, op het ogenblik geloof ik zelfs een pion meer, maar hij heeft natuurlijk nog een probleem en dat is dit paard. Dit speelt helemaal niet mee. Het kan ook niet eens meedoen, want na paard C2 veld is niet beschikbaar, we werken lopen op B5. Dus dat is het nadeel van wit. Dat stuk doet niet mee en daar moet je een oplossing voor vinden. Ja, paard E5 is een zet, maar...
Paard E5 is een zet?
Ja, dat is een...
Ja.
The big problem in chess is that it is very hard to keep the concentration always on a high level. So there are some moments maybe where the concentration is not so perfect. And this is moments where you can make a mistake, and this is very dangerous in chess. You make one mistake because you are not 100% concentrated, and it's over. In tennis, you are missing the ball, okay, it's maybe not so terrible. You have a lot of opportunities. In chess, it could be end of the game if you miss it, some opportunities or some moves of opponent. In that sense, you need to be much more concentrated during the game. But at the same time, you need also maybe to use the time to relax during the game, because you cannot keep this concentration always, yes, for 4 hours. So many players, they are walking and just maybe to look at some other games, maybe just to switch attention a little bit. But of course, in the critical phase of the game, they're sitting and they're working very intensively.
You can play
okay,
knight.
I can c5. C5, yeah.
But then okay, I'm also coming.
Not enough, you know. I thought just we could play more interesting chess, but I think that would be better for black, you know, because in the game I think I could be worse, you know. If you didn't play rook, because I had a strange idea that you have to play bishop f3 here.
Yes,
f3,
no,
really
I wanted to play bishop, but then,
yeah, but
it's
then
too
I play bishop,
slow, bishop g6.
Yes, exactly. So that was. And then after knight f3, I don't know. But here, just you make, I mean, h3, for instance.
Yes, no,
I didn't see what I what bishop d4.
Yeah, well, actually, that's why I played here. Because,
yes,
okay, I saw knight c5 is not working.
Okay, it's not working with black, you know, this now after bishop b1, knight
c5. No, because, okay, I can even play like this. Well, because even this is a possibility, but then just go here, but then you're mating me.
So
yes,
that's what I wanted to avoid.
And if I take those h4s, you are always coming here. So I have this move. But this is also a little stupid. And
so
if I take?
Ah, sorry, no, you take. First you can take it. Wait, so, I mean, at least I can go knight g5.
Yeah, you can always go knight g5.
It's a better version of
yes.
the game.
No, I have to go for
so,
this.
So, and here.
This is a good
I mean, I. But then you take.
And then, yeah. And go here. Yeah, you have little chance of knight on d6. Nice.
Cb5, yes.
No, but okay.
It's like
wait a second, no.
Yeah. I think I had to exchange the rooks, you know, because in the game you're probably better.
Yes, probably I'm just.
Rook d4, yes.
Yes, I always have rook d4.
Yeah, rook d4, yeah. I think I'm.
Well, okay, I saw
him,
that
yes.
I'm just okay, but.
Yeah, because I saw the okay later on, but I don't think I needed rooks, so I had to. Take, you have to take with the queen.
Yes, I have to take.
And I go knight g5 now.
Yes.
I wasn't sure what I was supposed to do with queen f5. Here I.
No,
you know,
okay, you take.
Maybe, you know what could I do? Maybe I would take here.
And take here and queen g5. Yes, that's what I saw that you were going to do. And then I saw that I go b5. Anyway, and then
draw.
It's just a draw.
A
well,
draw.
Actually, that's what I saw.
Yes.
That you take here.
Yeah, okay, my original intention was to take here, but then.
But then rook d4.
Then you play rook d4.
And you don't have any.
And then you have floor. Key square.
Queen f4, yeah, this is.
Key square.
Then maybe.
It
should be
still
a draw.
Rook e1, queen
yes.
e5, knight h5, and knight goes on this. Still a draw.
Still
a draw.
Okay,
thank
yeah.
you.
All right.
Всего вот это один триггер есть. Ну как-то по-человечески. Условно бодрости. Почему я тут работаю? Ну хорошо, ферзь вот это 1-3 поставили бы там. Как ты опять пошел?
Ну лучше, да.
Нет, вы как-то просто слово 2.
Рано или поздно пойти.
Я готовлю.
Я думаю, что ферзь слово, словно 7 вот это 1 пойти, скажем.
Ну пока я поставил.
Ну пойти там, А2-3.
Может уже вернуться?
Ну я в любом случае, то есть я на это иду. Тут слон будет на b2, b4, конь
I think in general the audience never accept what happens to a chess player in that level. I think it's one of the hardest sports you can practice, it's chess. Because most of the people think chess is no sport, it's only a culture or art, something like that, but this is not the truth. You have to be physically in a very good shape to stand in such competitions because you need a high concentration all the time. And it means that you are losing height during a tournament. That means that you have to take care of your health, of everything else. And if you play, for example, something happens with your body because of the high concentration, that you really can call it a sports competition. I think around 200 in special situations they have. when they see winning or losing positions, when they are in time trouble, the pulse. I think a doctor checked it 2 years ago, and I think it's around 200 then in these situations. But this is not the point. This is, as in every sport, the same. The point is really the high concentration for many hours in the game. And it never leaves you alone after the game, not before the game. So you are in the game the whole time during a competition, and this has physically consequences. Yes, so it's tough.
The problem of a chess player is that when you play a good game, you feel, wow, I'm a superhuman. Yes, I could do this. I'm a fantastic player. While if you play badly, then you are feeling exactly the opposite. You want to find a hole in the earth to go down because you think you are not the same person anymore, which is actually, in fact, just fake, because you are still remaining the same person. Okay, you had a bad day, you played badly, but that's how chess players feel, and somehow you have to neutralize those feelings, but this comes also with experience. And this is really important in order to be successful for a long period of time.
Больше миллиона, это все вот за все, как мы старые.
Actually, I think Chuk played quite well. He was playing well.
He played very well. I mean, he can
No, he plus four, plus five, if this scrambling doesn't happen.
Yeah, I mean, he was winning both. This is not in the row. No, he could get so
He plays more so. Yeah.
So, we are just separate now. It's not the winners of us.
The final results. Besides the winner, there is always a player who has to finish on the last position. On the 14th place, with 4 points out of 13 games, good old Jan Timman.
Number 8, Peter Leko from Hungary. With a 50% score of 6.5 points. On a shared fifth space, Michael Adams from England. Seven and a half points out of 13 games. Thank you.
close. It's always nice to be here. It's nice to be at the stage. Nice to deliver the speech, and nice to keep up with the tradition. I'm very happy to hear that people in Wiekenzee, in Beverwijk, in Holland, in Chorus, they're really concerned about the tradition, because tradition is something that is not yet missed in the history of chess. It's not as missed in the current environment of the game of chess, but we can lose it. And it's very important if all people that value this tradition will fight for it, and if such event as at the tournament in Wiekenzee, Beverwijk, this tournament that has already 63 years of nearly perfect record. I think only 1 year was missed in 45. There was a good reason for that. I hope we'll never experience another 1945 in the history of chess. I never thought I would be so happy to come here and just to think about next year. It's not very warm outside. It's probably better than Moscow, but still, you know, you can't compete with Linares in weather. But I'm sure you can easily compete with Linares in strengths. I expect that we'll have more meetings to come. We'll have more warmth inside the tournament hall, and this tournament will end one tradition and start a new one, and we'll guarantee that the chess, the game that we love so much, will never be subjected to new regulations and new rules that could actually kill it. So I hope to see you next year. I hope to see you years to come. And thank you very much for having this great event.